Now a few items from our Freedom Files. Just when you thought the police's main objective was to help, think again. New York police officers allegedly gave Brooklyn-based junkie Melanie Perez crack and forced her to perform lewd sex acts. This is part of the scandalous details coming from the trial of Jason Arbeny, one of the 8 undercover NYPD cops that made up the Brooklyn South Narcotics Squad. Previous testimony revealed these cops allegedly planted drugs on innocent people in order to meet their quotas and in order to receive overtime compensation. And now the testimony of Ms. Perez alleges that she was lured to an officer's home where he gave her drugs and then demanded he be compensated through sex acts. America, police officers have a responsibility to serve and protect their community and to protect freedom. But they also possess tremendous power, power which can be abused. Freedom Watch, as you know, will continue to keep an eye on this case and others like it. The Justice Department is turning a blind eye, however, to 2 D.C. Metro Transit cops who slammed a man in a wheelchair at a subway stop. The police allege the man was drinking, that he refused to leave the premises while resisting arrest, and that his refusal, quote, resulted in him falling out of his wheelchair. Apparently, the Department of Justice bought that ridiculous story, even though both the drinking and the assault charges have been dropped. I wonder why. And the DOJ chose to believe the cop's version of this story, despite video evidence that proved the cops were indeed the aggressors. Look at this, how he's resisting arrest, all right? The video of the May 19th incident has already gone viral, but the DOJ spokesperson said there wasn't enough evidence to bring charges against the 2 cops. She said, quote, accident, mistake, fear, negligence, bad judgment are not sufficient to establish a criminal violation. Really? I wonder if she would say that to any other non-police American accused of a crime. It's a sour situation that turned a little sweeter. Freedom Watch brought you the story of the Lemonistas who were arrested for selling 10 cents a cup lemonade on the long lawn of the United States Capitol building. These peaceful demonstrators and entrepreneurs were facing jail time. But tonight, Freedom Watch can happily inform you that the charges have been dropped. The Lemonistas were protesting against the various kids' lemonade stands that local governments shut down this past summer. And while the Lemonistas' story has a happy ending, so far it has not led to any overturn of the big government laws that led to the kids' stands being shut down in the first place. Lemonade stands may seem like a silly thing to stand up for, but backing these stands really means backing free market, limited government principles on which our country was founded. If you listen to mainstream media, Libya is free from dictatorship now that Gaddafi is gone.